Mitro, namaskar. Good afternoon, colleagues, friends. You are welcome once again here today. You might be wondering why I'm doing this briefing today instead of tomorrow. I'll come to that. But before I start the formal part of this interaction, let me mention here that in this hall today we are privileged to have some individuals who will not be asking questions, because they would, in due course of time, will be at the receiving end of your questions. I welcome here to the Ministry of External Affairs the officer trainees or the probationers of the Indian Information Service. Welcome, all of you. Now, I have an announcement to make. And the announcement is that the 8th Heads of Mission Conference will be held in New Delhi from tomorrow onwards, from 4th to 7th of May this year, obviously, from tomorrow. And this Heads of Mission Conference, as the previous conferences have done in the past couple of years, will extensively deliberate the important matters in foreign policy and implementation of the foreign policy, as well as it will touch upon the housekeeping issues of the ministry and the missions. So that was the brief announcement. And it also gives you the reason why I will not be able to do the press conference tomorrow. So I thought, rather than not doing the press briefing at all, it is better to do it a day in advance. So that's why I'm here. And with this announcement, I have no further announcements to make. I'm in your hands. Aditya, and after that, Ashish.
So we've seen the horrific incident taking place at the line of control in the Krishna Ghati sector. We've seen two of our jawans from the BSF and the Indian Army being mutilated. And this incident is not the first one. We've seen that happening in October and November as well. What has been the reaction? We heard that the Pak envoy was summoned, but what is the counteraction that India is really planning, diplomatic or otherwise? Thank you.
Ashish, is your question also related to this? Then in which case I will club all the questions pertaining to this particular matter. Yes, Ashish.
Sir, I'm told that the High Commissioner of Pakistan went today, was summoned by the Foreign Secretary. Pakistani side is asking for actionable evidence of the incident that Aditya just referred to. So are we considering to give something to them?
मेरा सवाल सर ये है कि पठानकोट हमले के बाद भारत ने लगातार ये मुहिम चलाई थी कि दुनिया भर से अलग थलग कर दिया जाए एक आतंक के मामले में पाकिस्तान को और एक आतंकी देश के तौर पर घोषित किया जाए, तो हमारी मुहिम आखिर उसके बाद से कमजोर क्यों हुई, धीमी क्यों पड़ गई?
यस श्रीजय.
So it's not just this one. I mean, there's been, in these months, there's been Pathankot, Uri, Nagrota, and then three incidents of mutilation in Machil and the one several days ago. In all these cases, Pakistan has been involved. Have we got any kind of response from them on any of these incidents?
There has been a lot of speculation regarding Nawaz Sharif Sajjan Jindal meeting.
Let me stop you there. I'll take this question. Yeah. But first, let me confine to this matter of mutilation of the body and the killing of our soldiers across the LOC. I mean, this side of the LOC. Yeah, Ritu.
Sir, the India-Pakistan relationship seems to follow a pattern, a set pattern which the Indian diplomats or the Indian diplomatic setup has failed to break or change. Do you think that Pakistan or the neighbor in the West has been the biggest headache so far for the Indian diplomats?
Are you asking it in the specific context of this particular incident? All right. Then I will take it, otherwise I would have to defer it. Yeah.
So there have been some reports in the Pakistani media that this industrialist, Sajjan Jindal, was actually carrying
I'll finish this LOC part. Yes.
There are reports that 47 school students from Pakistan sent
it's back. It's not related to the LOC. Please confine your questions right now to the incident across the line of control which has been perpetrated on us. If there is any other question, no other question on this, then
I'll... I wanted to seek details about this summoning of the High Commissioner and what was his response. Thanks.
So, thank you for your questions. You would have seen the tweet from the MEA handle and the details which we have given. I would give you a little more of details that I know. And I will, of course, repeat this. Main isko fir Hindi mein dohraunga kyunki mahatvapurn vishay hai aur isko jahan tak sambhav ho, main koshish karunga ki Hindi, jo main Angrezi mein keh raha hu, main fir uske baad usko Hindi mein kahun. As you know, the Pakistan High Commissioner was summoned to MEA today at around noontime. In the brief meeting with the High Commissioner, our Foreign Secretary conveyed India's outrage, and this we have mentioned to you already in the tweet. India's outrage at the killing and the barbaric act of mutilation of the bodies of two Indian soldiers on May 1st, 2017 by Pakistan Army personnel. It was conveyed that the government considers it a strong act of provocation and in contravention to all norms of civilized conduct. It is significant that the attack was preceded by a covering fire from Pakistani posts in the Batal sector in the vicinity of village Batal. Blood samples of the Indian soldiers that have been collected and the trail of blood on the Roza Nala line clearly shows that the killers returned across the line of control. So this answers the part about the evidence, what actionable evidence we have right now, the information that we have provided to Pakistan. We have shared this already with the Pakistan High Commissioner. The Indian side has sufficient evidence that this act was committed by personnel of the Pakistan Army who crossed the line of control in the Krishna Ghati sector. The government also demanded that Pakistan take immediate action against its soldiers and commanders responsible for this heinous act. Ab main Hindi mein isko batane ki koshish karta hu. Pakistan ke uchayukt ko aaj videsh mantralay mein bulaya gaya. Videsh mantralay mein unse jo sankshipt bhet hui uske dauran, us mulaqat ke dauran videsh sachiv ne unko उन तक जो भारत में इस घटना को लेकर के आक्रोश है, जो रशियंस हत्या करी गई है पूरी बर्बरता के साथ और अंग भंग किया गया है भारत के दो जवानों का, सिपाहियों का, 1 मई को पाकिस्तान आर्मी के सिपाहियों द्वारा हमारी साइड पे एलओसी की लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल नियंत्रण रेखा के हमारी तरफ, उस पर भारत में जो आक्रोश व्याप्त है, जो क्रोध है, आक्रोश है इस बर्बरतापूर्ण नृशंस हत्या पर, उसको विदेश सचिव ने पाकिस्तान के उच्चायुक्त को बताया और उन्होंने ये भी बताया कि भारत सरकार इस घटना को समझती है कि ये सभ्यता के सारे ही जो मापदंड हैं उसके परे है, उनके विपरीत है और एक उकसाने की घटना भी है। ये महत्वपूर्ण बात है कि इस नृशंस हत्या के पहले जो पाकिस्तान की पोस्ट्स हैं नियंत्रण रेखा के उस पार, उनसे गोलीबारी करी गई हमारी तरफ और उन्होंने इस चीज़ को इस घटना को कवर करने के लिए जो पाकिस्तान की टीम एक्ट कर रही थी उसकी सहायता करी, उसको कवर फायर प्रोवाइड किया। जो खून के नमूने हैं जो हमारे सिपाहियों के हैं खून के नमूने, उनसे और जो खून की जो निशानदेही है, जो निशानी वहाँ पे ज़मीन पर है, उससे ये पता चलता है कि जो पाकिस्तान से आए थे वो पाकिस्तान में नियंत्रण रेखा पार करके वापस चले गए। और हमारे पास इस बात के पुख्ता सबूत हैं कि ये घटना, ये हत्या पाकिस्तान आर्मी के लोगों ने करी है और नियंत्रण रेखा को पार करके, नियंत्रण रेखा के इस पार आ करके उन्होंने इस घटना को अंजाम दिया है और ये उन्होंने कृष्णा घाटी सेक्टर में किया। और इसलिए भारत सरकार ने ये मांग करी है पाकिस्तान से कि उनकी सेना में जो भी सिपाही या उनके कमांडर्स इस घटना के लिए ज़िम्मेदार हैं उत्तरदायी हैं उनके खिलाफ तुरंत उचित कार्रवाई करी जाए. सो आई थिंक आई हैव आंसर्ड द पार्ट अबाउट सम अदर डिटेल्स दैट यू वांटेड फ्रॉम द फॉरेन सेक्रेटरीज ब्रीफ मीटिंग एंड कन्वर्सेशन विद द पाकिस्तान हाई कमिश्नर. Also about the evidence part of it, that what we have right now, we have conveyed to Pakistan. आप लोगों ने आपने एक सवाल पूछा था कि जो हमारी मुहिम थी पाकिस्तान को अलग थलग करने की. देखिए ये बात जाहिर है कि हम आज से नहीं बल्कि दशकों से, चार दशक से भी ज़्यादा से आतंकवाद के और जो सीमा पार से हमारे ऊपर आतंकवाद थोपा गया है उसके शिकार हैं. भारत उसका शिकार है, भारत के लोग उसका शिकार हुए हैं. तो ये कोई नई बात नहीं है. जो सरकार ने कोशिश करी पठानकोट अटैक के बाद, पठानकोट आतंकी हमले के बाद और ख़ासकर उरी के आतंकवादी हमले के बाद, इन जो पिछले साल सितंबर में हुआ था, उसके परिणाम स्वरूप भारत सरकार की कोशिशों और हमारी नीति के परिणाम स्वरूप विश्व में एक ये सोच बनी कि जो भारत की नीति है वो सही है. उसका उसको समर्थन मिला. इस बात को समर्थन मिला कि अंतर्राष्ट्रीय आतंकवाद और सीमा पार से चलाया जा रहा आतंकवाद जो हमारा क्षेत्र है उसकी शांति और स्थिरता के लिए बहुत ही गंभीर खतरा है और इस खतरे का अंत किया जाना चाहिए. इस सीमा पार के आतंकवाद को समाप्त किया जाना चाहिए. इस बारे में किसी को कोई दो राय नहीं है. आपने पिछले साल जो भारत की हमारे नेताओं की जो मुलाकातें हुई हैं विश्व के अग्रणी नेताओं से, अन्य नेताओं से, उनके जॉइंट स्टेटमेंट देखे होंगे. आपने यहाँ तक कि अभी टर्की वाला जो जॉइंट स्टेटमेंट है जो अभी हाल ही में इशू हुआ है उसमें भी ये बात कही गई है कि क्रॉस बॉर्डर टेररिज्म मस्ट बी स्टॉप्ड. और तमाम दुनिया के नेताओं ने इस बात कहा है कि क्रॉस बॉर्डर टेररिज्म मस्ट बी स्टॉप्ड. तो इसमें हमारी नीति में, हमारे काम, हमारे उस नीति के क्रियान्वयन में किसी प्रकार की कोई शिथिलता नहीं है. दुनिया की निगाह में, दुनिया के नज़रिए में किसी प्रकार का बदलाव नहीं है. वो हमारे समर्थन में और आतंकवाद के खिलाफ है. दुर्भाग्य की बात है कि जो इस आतंकवाद को बढ़ावा दे रहे हैं और इस आतंकवाद को हमारे ऊपर थोप रहे हैं उनकी गतिविधियों में परिवर्तन आया कि नहीं आया, ये सवाल अभी भी बना हुआ है. लेट मी कंप्लीट दी. Now, I can tell you that you know the history, Shinjoy, the what has happened in the last months. I don't want to repeat that about the Pathankot incident and the Uri incident. That is very well in the public domain. Our views on that are also on the public domain, in the public domain. As far as today's meeting is concerned, I can tell you that the Foreign Secretary mentioned to the High Commissioner of Pakistan that we hope that as the High Commissioner of Pakistan, he would convey to his government the sense of outrage that exists in India on this particular incident, on this barbaric act. And well, his response was that he of course denied that Pakistan army was involved in the in any way in this incident, but assured that he will convey the contents of our demarche. तो हिंदी में भी इसको बता देता हूँ कि जहाँ तक उन्होंने जवाब में क्या कहा इसका सवाल है. तो आज जो मुलाकात हुई उसमें विदेश सचिव ने पाकिस्तान के उच्चायुक्त से कहा कि उच्चायुक्त होने के नाते हम ये उम्मीद करते हैं कि वो अपनी सरकार को सही तरीके से जो हमने आक्रोश की भावना, क्रोध की भावना भारत में व्याप्त है इस नृशंस हत्या को लेकर, उसको जो हमने बताया है उनको, वो एक उच्चायुक्त होने के नाते अपनी सरकार को एकदम सही तरीके से वो उस चीज़ को अपनी सरकार तक पहुंचाएंगे. तो उन्होंने, उच्चायुक्त साहब ने कहा कि पाकिस्तान की सेना ने इसमें कोई हिस्सा नहीं लिया इस घटना में, लेकिन वो हमने जो कुछ उनसे कहा है वो उसे अपनी सरकार तक पहुंचा देंगे. नाउ आई थिंक रितु, यू हैड आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन अबाउट अ सेट पैटर्न ऑफ इंडिया पाकिस्तान रिलेशंस. I think I have answered this question today also, that this is an unfortunate reality in our region, that cross-border terrorism continues to pose a very grave threat to peace and stability in our region, as well as threaten the security of neighbors of the country which is perpetuating it. And everyone in the international community agrees that it must be brought to an end.
Sir, the answer that you have given about the evidence that we have given, I just need a clarification on that. The blood samples that have been collected belong to Indian soldiers, and then we have a trail of blood that goes back to Pakistan, and that we are using as an evidence that there were people who came across the border. My question is that the trail of blood belongs to Indian soldiers or the people who came from across the border?
First of all, let me clarify that those who came from across the line of control did not come from Pakistan. They came from Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Secondly, it's obvious that they returned to where they came from. So the trail of blood is of Pakistanis who came across. In this case, personnel of Pakistani army. I would suggest you take a microphone.
Just in continuation to her question, you said that this is the blood of, the trail of blood is of Pakistan personnel. How do we have DNA evidence to say that it is Pakistan personnel or somebody from LOC? It could be a terrorist, a non-state actor. How do we, that is definitely a question that Pakistan is going to raise. So do we have our evidence there?
Thank you for your question. I think we have the evidence as to where that blood trail came. Came from.
Gopal, I want to clarify, seek a clarification. You said the blood samples on the Indian side were of the Indian soldiers. Do you want to say that they carried some part of the mutilated part of the Indian soldiers across the border? Is that the trail of blood? Because how do you justify the trail of blood crossing over?
Does anybody have a related question? Kadamti, get the microphone, please.
Are there two sets of evidence, one of Indian soldiers and one others?
Maha, you wanted to ask some question on this? All right. All right, please.
Sir, are there any other diplomatic measures that India is going to use against Pakistan? What is India mulling?
सर एक क्लारिफिकेशन ये जानना है कि जो एविडेंस है क्या वो एविडेंस शेयर किया गया है कमिश्नर के साथ मतलब ब्लड सैंपल्स की रिपोर्ट हम लोगों ने शेयर की है या केवल ये बताया कि वो सबूत हमारे पास है
सर जस्ट वांटेड वन क्लारिफिकेशन द ब्लड ट्रेल इज ऑफ इंडियन सोल्जर्स और ऑफ पाकिस्तानी पर्सनल एंड इफ इट्स ऑफ पाकिस्तानी पर्सनल हाउ डिड बी डिफरेंशिएटेड दैट इट्स नॉट द ब्लड ऑफ एन इंडियन पर्सन बट ऑफ अ पाकिस्तानी What proof do we have? How did we match it?
Anyone else on this particular issue? Yeah. Pranay.
Sir, इससे पहले जितनी भी घटनाएं हुई हैं, उसमें हमने BAT, जिसको Border Action Teams कहते हैं, उसके composition को लेके एक ambiguity रखी है, लेकिन इस बार हम pinpoint कर रहे हैं कि इसके लिए पाकिस्तान आर्मी ही responsible है, सीधे-सीधे पाकिस्तानी troops, जो DGMO का statement है, उसमें भी हमने BAT camps की बात की है, तो आप clarify करेंगे BAT camps क्या हैं? और दूसरी चीज़ ये कि ये पाकिस्तानी आर्मी ही है ये हम किस श्योरिटी के साथ किन एविडेंसेस के आधार पर कह रहे हैं
और रंजीत
ये जो ब्लड सैंपल आप कह रहे हैं कि पाकिस्तानी सोल्जर्स के हो सकते हैं तो क्या पाकिस्तानी सोल्जर्स इंजर्ड होकर के वापस लौटे हैं क्या ऐसी कोई घटना हुई है जिससे कि वो खून बहते हुए वापस लौटते चले हुए चले गए
फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू लेट मी रिपीट व्हाट आई रेड आउट in the beginning, this particular part about the blood samples, okay? Blood samples and the trail of blood. Blood samples of the Indian soldiers that have been collected and the trail of blood on Roza Nala clearly shows that the killers returned across the line of control, okay? So this is the detail that I have at the moment. So I think it clarifies the situation absolutely. It does. This is the detail I have at the moment, which I have shared with you. The blood samples and the trail, it clearly showed blood samples are of the Indian soldiers, obviously, because they are our soldiers, they are on our side. The people who came from Pakistan side of line of control, that is the Pakistan occupied Kashmir side, they returned to Pakistan occupied Kashmir side, but there is a trail of blood leading up to the line of control. I'm only saying that these are the two sets of information that we have at the moment.
No, but the trail of blood, the trail of blood at the Rozanada, is that of our troops or not?
The trail of blood at the Rozanala is an indication that the people who came from Pakistan returned to Pakistan. This is all the information I have at the moment. All right? Well, I don't think it is ambiguous, so I would suggest we leave it at that. Can I move on to other questions? Because you see, here the basic point is, the basic point nobody is disputing out of you, that the people came from Pakistan, occupied Kashmir, they crossed the line of control, they perpetrated this act, and then they went back. Now the question is that what we have told the Pakistan High Commissioner, I am confining my information to you on what we have told the Pakistan High Commissioner. We have told the Pakistan High Commissioner that we have enough evidence. And within that enough evidence, we have mentioned this particular thing. And also the fact that the Pakistani post across Batal, our Batal post, in the village Batal, they carried out the cover fire. All right? Now the question about Pranay that you asked, ki humko kaise hum kya is baat se aashwast hain kya hame yakeen hai ki ye Pakistan army ke hi log the, ji ha hame yakeen hai aur isiliye humne kyunki bharat sarkar koi bhi baat bina pukhta jankari ke nahi kahegi aur humne sarkari taur par Pakistan ke uchayukt ko ye kaha hai ki aur main repeat kar dun main fir se pad deta hu us cheez ko the foreign secretary conveyed India's outrage at the killing and the barbaric act of mutilation of the bodies of two Indian soldiers on May 1st by Pakistan army personnel. So I think that takes care of this particular part. Would you like to move on to other questions now?
Sir,
yeah. We have told them that we have enough evidence. At the moment, we have told them that we have enough evidence.
Yes, sir. This is a general tendency nowadays, that people are offering India to mediate on the issue of Kashmir between India and Pakistan. It began with President Trump, and then Trump, President Trump also, when he came and he offered. Then Mr. Erdogan, he was there here, and he also offered the same thing. And now Chinese are offering that they will mediate between India and Pakistan on the issue of Kashmir. So are you failing in conveying the message that Kashmir is a bilateral issue and no other country has any say or right to speak in this thing? And had this issue been raised when Mr. Erdogan was there, because the same day Pakistan has mutilated our soldiers, so was it told to him that see what is happening between India and Pakistan?
Let me answer your question, but I missed out on answering Maha. Further steps, Maha, I think we will have to wait and watch, wait and see what the steps would be. You have seen the statements coming out of Ministry of Defense and our army that you are familiar with. I would refer you to them. But I would also say that summoning the Pakistan High Commissioner was within the competence of the ministry that I represent, the Ministry of External Affairs. We have done that today. And let us wait and see. Let me not jump to conclusions or speculate as to what we will do in future. Now, Akhileshji, your question. Look, first thing first, there is no ambiguity in government's position, and it is very clearly known to our interlocutors. I would like to remind you that the State Department of the United States on this matter has pronounced themselves very clearly, the US position. And not once, but several times in the past. As for what you are referring to, the remarks by the president of Turkey who recently visited India, I think what you are referring to is his remarks in a section of media that was carried before his visit. But I can tell you, as I told you on that day, that this aspect, the particular aspect that you asked, did not figure in our conversations. And I told you that day what we mentioned to him on Kashmir. As far as the Chinese remark that you are referring to is concerned, so far as I am aware, this is carried in one of their publications. So I normally don't comment on media views expressed by media, but I understand this is carried in the segment of the Chinese media. I can only advise that segment of the Chinese media to first of all understand the Chinese position on Jammu and Kashmir carefully and closely. To our understanding, the Chinese position has been that India, that Jammu and Kashmir is a matter to be addressed by India and Pakistan.
सर उड़ी और पठानकोट हमले के बाद जो दो महत्वपूर्ण सवाल उठे थे उसमें एक था मोस्ट फेवर्ड नेशन का दर्जा जो पाकिस्तान को दिया गया है क्या वो समाप्त किया जाएगा और एलिनेट करने के अलावा दूसरा सवाल था इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी को लेकर लेकिन हाल में ये भी देखने को मिल रहा है कि वाटर सेड मैनेजमेंट को लेकर भी पाकिस्तान जो है इंडिया और अफगानिस्तान से बातचीत कर रहा है एग्जैक्ट पोजिशन क्या है इन दोनों इशूज पर
I will answer in Hindi and then I will try and render it in English for the benefit of those correspondents who would follow English and not Hindi. देखिए जो जहाँ तक सिंधु जल संधि का इंडस वाटर्स ट्रीटी का सवाल है वो 1960 से भारत और पाकिस्तान के बीच में जो जलों का बंटवारा है या उसकी शेयरिंग है उसकी साझेदारी है उसके बारे में है और आप लोगों ने मुझसे पिछले महीने नहीं मार्च में ये सवाल किया था तो उसकी जो कमीशन की मीटिंग थी वो भी इसी बारे में थी कि संधि का किस प्रकार से क्रियान्वयन किया जाता है उसके लिए वो एक ट्रीटी स्टिपुलेटेड बॉडी है संधि के अंतर्गत जो मैकेनिज्म है जो संयंत्र बनाया गया है वो किस प्रकार से काम करता है उसके बारे में वो मीटिंग थी तो वो स्थिति हमने आपको तब भी बताई थी और उसमें वो मीटिंग जहाँ तक मुझे याद है मार्च के महीने में पाकिस्तान में हुई थी अब पाकिस्तान अफगानिस्तान से क्या बात कर रहा है इस संबंध में मैं कोई टिप्पणी जाहिर सी बातें नहीं कहना चाहूँगा जहाँ तक मोस्ट फेवर्ड नेशन स्टेटस का मामला है वो हमने 1996 में पाकिस्तान को दिया था वो एक आप ये ध्यान रखिए कि ये WTO के अंतर्गत वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अंतर्गत एक ऑब्लिगेशन है एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय हमारे ऊपर ज़रूरी है कि हम ये करें ये सारे WTO मेंबर्स पर लागू होता है और ये चीज़ कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि खाली इंडिया ने पाकिस्तान के साथ मोस्ट फेवर्ड नेशन स्टेटस किया हुआ है द क्वेश्चन ऑफ द करस्पॉन्डेंट हियर वाज अबाउट इंडिया हैविंग एक्सटेंडेड MFN स्टेटस टू पाकिस्तान इन 1996 एंड द कन्वर्सेशन दैट परहैप्स टुक प्लेस इन सम क्वार्टर्स व्हेन पठानकोट एंड उरी अटैक्स हैपेंड लास्ट ईयर अबाउट विदड्रॉइंग दिस MFN स्टेटस एंड ऑल्सो पाकिस्तान टॉकिंग टू अफगानिस्तान एंड इंडिया अबाउट वाटर शेड मैनेजमेंट एंड वॉट इज हैपनिंग टू द इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी सो माई आंसर वॉज दैट इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी इज बीन देयर फॉर शेयरिंग ऑफ वाटर्स बिटवीन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान सिंस 1960 इट्स मैकेनिज्म इज द परमानेंट इंडस कमीशन टू इम्प्लीमेंट इट विच मेट इन मार्च एंड दैट्स वॉट हैपेंड इन द मंथ ऑफ मार्च As far as MFN status is concerned, it is a WTO obligation that all WTO members must extend to each other, and that's by India, that's not Pakistan specific. Yeah, Ian? Ian first and then Pallav.
I said two quick questions. One, just very simply, is India's military considering any sort of retaliation? And second, has India been in touch with the United States on its response?
Well, I'm sure, Ian, you don't expect me to answer the first question here in public. But I would tell you that we have taken a step today, which you would have seen, by summoning the High Commissioner. And I devoted sufficient time today in this particular briefing to answering that particular question. Of what we have done today. So let me not speculate into what, as I told Maha, that let me not speculate into what we will be doing in the next days or not doing. And I'm personally not aware if we have spoken to the United States in this regard, but I can check this out. or whether they have spoken to us in this regard.
Gopal, changing track, or let's say changing orbit, this week we are seeing a major foreign policy initiative through the South Asia satellite. One, can you throw some light on it? And do you have, what is the drill? Are the heads of state of South Asian nations, friendly nations, participating, coming, or a video conference, or what is likely to happen?
Thank you, Palla, for that question. I think you are right that the launch of the South Asia satellite, which the Prime Minister had announced, I think, way back in 2014, within a few weeks of assuming his office, I think that is, as of now, scheduled for 5th of May, as far as I understand. But as you know, these things are subject to weather conditions and everything else. So, but as of now, it is scheduled for 5th of May, which is later this week. This is a major initiative. In fact, if I could use these words, that it is taking the Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas policy of the government to another level. It's extending the Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas policy to stratospheric levels, and even beyond. So it is basically our neighborhood first. We want to share what we have, more connectivity, more sharing with our neighbors. Pallav, I am not aware as of now as to what is going to be the drill, but I understand that our ministry and ISRO are in touch, and they are working out the details of the event related to the launch on that particular day.
Sir, Pakistan hasn't joined South Asia satellite. Does it show that Pakistan has always been scuttling, which is of a cooperative nature for the South Asian countries, including the SAARC summit? Can you also give update on that also? Anything on that?
No, I have no update on SAARC summit as of now. As to the approach of Pakistan that you mentioned about the initiatives within SAARC, I think I don't need to add anything to what already is in public domain. I can only speak about Government of India's policy, that has been to promote cooperation within the region, because that means more connectivity, that means more trade, that means more prosperity. I'm reminded of the one question rule. All right. Kindly take microphone.
Hi. Going back to China and JNK, construction of roads in POK is currently underway, and China has vested interest in protecting the $50 billion investment in the China-Pakistan economic corridor. What is India's response to the continued construction of roads in POK?
I think we have made this position very clear on a number of occasions earlier on, that the part where this construction is taking place or supposed to take place in future, also, that part belongs to India. It is sovereign Indian territory, because the entire state of Jammu and Kashmir had acceded legally to the Union of India in 1947, and therefore the part that is under Pakistan's illegal occupation, that is sovereign Indian territory. So our position on the ongoing projects or whatever has happened there or is happening or is going to happen is amply clear. On the aspect of vested interest that you quoted, I think it is also from the same publication, that same article, and I think I have answered that question already. On Sajjan Jindal, I think I have nothing to add. He's a private individual. He apparently, reportedly met the leader of another country, so it's not my domain to comment. But in order to be helpful to you, I would only refer you to the tweet which the daughter of the Prime Minister of Pakistan issued in the virtual space after the reported meeting of the two individuals.
पाकिस्तान से 47 स्कूली बच्चे आए हुए थे जिन्हें वापस भेज दिया गया है और कहा गया है कि बॉर्डर पे तनाव के कारण ऐसा किया गया है तो क्या पीपल टू पीपल कांटेक्ट के दूसरे क्षेत्रों में भी भारत पाकिस्तान तनाव का असर और बढ़ने जा रहा है
यू हैव अ रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन ऑल द टू ऑफ बोथ ऑफ यू नो ओके आगे दे दीजिए पहले there is a related question on this.
There are reports that Indian High Commission in Pakistan has refused visas to some wrestlers who were to participate in some event in India. And before that, there were similar event of some squash players have also been refused visa. So it is the political decision that no visas will be given to the players or artists coming from Pakistan?
Well, I will tell you specifically in all these three cases. First, let me answer in that order in which they were asked. जो स्कूल के बच्चों की आपने बात करी, 47 स्कूल के बच्चे, मुझे नंबर नहीं पता कितने थे, 47 थे या कम या ज़्यादा थे, लेकिन पाकिस्तान के स्कूल के बच्चे एक एनजीओ ने यहाँ पर इनवाइट किए थे. और जब हमें ये घटना ये उनका आगमन मेरे ख्याल से भारत में उसी दिन के आसपास हुआ था जिस दिन ये दुर्घटनापूर्ण बर्बरतापूर्ण घटना घटी, हमारे जवानों की हत्या करी गई और उनका अंग भंग किया गया. तो हमने हमारे मंत्रालय ने, विदेश मंत्रालय ने उस एनजीओ को ये सलाह दी कि ये उपयुक्त समय नहीं है इस प्रकार के आदान प्रदान के लिए. दिस इज़ नॉट एन अप्रोप्रिएट टाइम फॉर सच एक्सचेंजेस. दिस इज़ द एडवाइस दैट द मिनिस्ट्री कन्वेड टू द एनजीओ आफ्टर वी लर्न दैट द चिल्ड्रेन हैड क्रॉस्ड ओवर इन टू इंडिया on 1st May, which unfortunately is also the date on which the mutilation and killing of our soldiers took place on our side of the line of control. So that answers your question. About the squash team, well, I can only tell you that the visas had been approved well before the commencement, the date of commencement of the event. But I do not know for what reasons the concerned individuals did not want to take their visas. Wrestlers? Yes. Wrestlers, I think just a few minutes ago before I came to this conference, you might have seen the comments made by Minister of State for Youth Affairs and Sports. I have nothing further to add. All right, the last four questions. We have already been going on now for 40 minutes, 45 minutes. Shastri sir, please.
This is relating to the Universal Periodic Review that's coming up in the UN Human Rights Council. Are the submissions made by the National Human Rights Commission, you know, at variance with the position of the government of India, particularly on the Convention Against Torture, where the commission's recommendation says that the government's view is mendacious and it has not acted on 5 years, and it has made strong comments on freedom of religion as well as on Kashmir. I would like to know how much it is at variance with the official position of the government of India. Thank you.
Let me attempt to answer that question. Thank you very much for that question. The UPR, Universal Periodic Review, is essentially a sort of a voluntary peer review mechanism which takes place. I mean, there is a cycle of 4 years. So my understanding is that last time it was in 2012. And before that also, India's record had been similarly reviewed in 2008. So it's every 4 years, 2008, 12. Now this is, to my information and understanding, this is the third. This is going to be the third such one. It is important to understand that this is a voluntary mechanism. This is a voluntary thing, and it is a peer review. It is reviewed by your peers. Let me not go into what the government's position is, because that would be known tomorrow. I understand that the Indian delegation is either already in Geneva or in way to Geneva, and they will be making their report in Geneva tomorrow, sometime Geneva's afternoon. So once the Indian position is put up, then I can comment on this. And therefore, I'm very sorry, I'm not able to comment on the divergence aspect of NHRC with the Indian report, because I don't know the Indian report. It is still to come in the public domain. But the fact is that because it is a peer review, a number of comments are made by different stakeholders. Now, if you really look at the role of the National Human Rights Commission, it is one of the strongest human rights commission the world has seen. And we are very proud of it. It is actually a symbol, a very strong, potent symbol of Indian democracy. And that adds to the vibrancy of the Indian democracy and the checks and balances to protect and promote democratic freedoms and fundamental rights of our citizens. But I won't be able to comment at this stage on the divergence aspect. Maha? Right there. Yeah.
Thank you. Nepal is going to have local elections after a gap of 20 years. What is the extent of support they have sought, and what is the support we have already extended to them? Thank you.
As you know, there was a telephone conversation between the Prime Minister and the President of Nepal few days ago. And we have offered the assistance to Nepal and support to Nepal. In general terms, as you know, peace and stability in Nepal is of paramount importance for India. And we are always in support of efforts that in Nepal to promote peace and inclusive participatory democracy. I think local elections, from our own experience also, we know that they are an important tool in any functioning democracy and in consolidation of democracy at the grassroots level. So we have offered, the Prime Minister has offered the support to the government of Nepal and any assistance that Nepal may require. As you know, we always, even in unfortunate occasions like the earthquake, we have been among the first responders. We are the closest neighbor of Nepal. Nepal is our closest neighbor. So whatever assistance they are asked will certainly be considered. Nanima, you have a question?
Sir, any update on Vijay Mallya now that the joint team of ED and CBI is there? Any more diplomatic measures that's being taken?
Nanima, what I can tell you right now is that there is a process underway in United Kingdom. If I'm not mistaken, there was some development last month, and Mr. Mallya was granted bail by a UK court, I think the Westminster court. If I am not mistaken, and my memory doesn't fail me, the next date has been set for 17th May. So that is, there is a process, internal process ongoing within the United Kingdom. I can say only this much at this stage. Gautam Saab, last question.
So my question relates to BDIN project. So now the Bhutan parliament has rejected that proposal. So are we going ahead with the BDIN project, and whether it's a setback for the sub-regional cooperation?
No, I think you must, I don't think it's a setback. And first of all, that is not the fact of what has happened. It is our understanding that all members of BBIN are fully committed to sub-regional cooperation within the BBIN framework. However, it is natural that all members may not have the same speed and may not have the same speed on all matters. So we continue to consult the BBIN members on ways and means to foster sub-regional cooperation in areas of common interest. I think I would request you, Gautam Saab, to kindly have a look very closely and carefully as to what actually have happened in Bhutan and why. Because it's a development in another country, I won't like to comment more than that at this stage. But it's not a setback, and it is not a rejection. Thank you very much. Thank you all, and hope to see you, I don't know, next week or not. I'm not sure.